Greetings, everyone, in the name of the Lord Jesus. Certainly, we are very grateful again to be back here in the house of God in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. We certainly give due respect always to the Lord Jesus Christ. We honor and adore him. There's no God greater than him, and he's certainly worthy to be praised. We certainly give due respect always to our deceased brethren of the past, those being the prophets of old and the apostles of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We give due respect to Pastor Jennings, our dearly beloved brother and pastor. We're so very grateful for him and the work that God has him doing in this day and time. We want to greet the saints of God everywhere, certainly those in the continent of Africa and throughout the various countries that are there, Mozambique and Malawi and other South Africa, other places in the continent of Africa. We're certainly grateful that God has blessed us to be able at this time to be able to broadcast live to you from the United States. We greet you all in the name of the Lord Jesus. This is the most precious thing that you've come in contact with in your life. And the purpose of this program is certainly to reach not just the continent of Africa, but those in other continents always with the one true gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. We're so very grateful again to the Lord Jesus. This is March the 12th, I believe it is, the year 2021. And is our first direct live broadcast to the continent of Africa, and we're certainly grateful for that. Again, this broadcast is coming to you from the First Church of our Lord Jesus Christ, our address 5105 North 5th Street in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, right here in the United States of America. At this time, we're going to present unto our leader, teacher, guide, and he's the messenger of the Almighty God, the Apostle, Pastor Gino Jennings.
Greetings, brothers and sisters. As always, we bear witness there is no God but one. We thank him and him alone for his divine wisdom and his perfect and infallible understanding of all things. We are indebted to him, for he is the true sender and true teacher of holy prophets and of holy apostles. We thank him for the way of holiness made known to his servants for our learning. I'm looking at the brothers and sisters that are gathered this evening there in Mozambique now while we're speaking. And I am so grateful for the technology that I can see the various countries that are gathered as they watch us. Friday service, we are reaching Malawi, Mozambique, Johannesburg, Cape Town, Mauritius. So we are grateful that you got a chance and you have a God-given chance to see your brothers and sisters from far. I'm glad to see Cape Town, South Africa. We thank God for all of you. They're waving and I'm waving too. So we are grateful that the word of God is being fulfilled, that men have sought out many inventions. I thank God because this is fulfilling the vision continuously, each stepping stone, each area of progress fulfills the vision that God had given us over 40 years ago for the salvation of our brothers and sisters the world over. We are looking to do this later on this year for Australia and New Zealand as well. And we also are looking to do a live webcast reaching our many brothers and sisters throughout the South Pacific. You know, the South Pacific is where China and Japan and Hawaii are located. Well, we have many First Churches of the Lord Jesus Christ on many islands throughout the South Pacific. Also, we're looking to do this our webcast reaching our brothers and sisters throughout India. We have over 50 temples in India, over 100 in East India. So we're looking forward to this. I'm glad to see our beautiful extended family. Many of them is walking into the temple there in Johannesburg, South Africa. So seeing this is very encouraging. I was sleepy earlier, but seeing this is waking me up. I am so grateful. I am so grateful. So, God willing, we will do this again later on this year as the different locations in Africa hold their general assembly, their holy convocation. I won't be able to fly there because of the pandemic. We're glad to see Bishop Simbali and Sister Simbali and my other brother there in the Mauritius Islands. We thank God to see you. Brother Elvis and the Saints, we thank God for you too. So it's a blessing to see our extended family. So because of the pandemic, they are banning, you know, a lot of overseas travel until one received the vaccine, and then I guess they will put some sort of stamp on your passport. But until all of this is successfully done, I will be in every convention virtual. We are making a virtual reality. Amen. And that way I can still be there among my extended family, bringing them the word of the Lord. All right, now, brothers and sisters, remember, we'll be back on tomorrow, 8 o'clock American time here in Philadelphia. And I believe this may be about 3:30 or 4 o'clock, depending upon what part of Africa this program is seen in. And on Saturday, same thing. Sunday morning, we'll do the same thing so we can work on you real good. All right, let's dive into the book of scriptures. Amen. In the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2, and begin at the 40th verse.
Acts chapter 2 and at verse 40.
Mm-hmm.
And with many other words did he testify and exhort, saying, save yourselves from this untoward generation.
Now, brothers and sisters, the apostles, who were the servants of the Most High God, had the lessons of God when he was here in the flesh. They walked with Jesus, talked with Jesus, ate with them, and handled him. They were eyewitnesses of his majesty. Let us remember that Jesus left a perfect, and I do mean a perfect example for everybody to follow. And without question, the apostles, the prophets, through and by divine revelation, and sometime by God giving them visions, showed them this day. That's something to think of. God gave them many visions to the prophets and the apostles. They described it many ways. But they saw this day. It wasn't physically here, but to be thousands of years ahead by the wisdom of God. They saw man seeking out many inventions, be it airplane, cars, trains, television, radio, internet. There's nothing. You see, when the word of God said there's nothing new under the sun, somebody in a carnal way of thinking would say, well, how can you say that? There was no internet in the days of the apostles.
I have also spoken by the prophets.
Listen at this.
In the book of Hosea, chapter 12, and at verse 10.
This is Hosea, the 12th chapter.
And the 10th verse.
And the 10th verse. Get this.
I have also spoken by the prophets.
I have also spoken by the prophets.
And I have multiplied vision.
I have multiplied. I gave the prophets many, many visions.
And used similitudes.
And I used different forms and different fashions and different figures. And how did God do it?
By the ministry of the prophets.
Glory to God.
That's right.
By the ministry of the prophet. So, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, God showed all sorts of things.
That's right.
To the prophets, showing them how his word would reach creation.
That's right.
Don't have to get on horseback no more. Don't have to get on the camel no more.
No.
But if I had to do it, I'll mount up.
Yes, you would.
Huh?
Yes, you would.
Prayer don't fall off, but God knows I'll mount up.
That's right.
So God made it now. You know, they have this thing that's another form of technology later on. I hope God bless us to experience a hologram. Yes, I want to do that. A hologram where they can take my physical body and beam me in another country. And my whole physical body look like I'm standing there. Not on the screen.
That's right.
But I'm actually standing there.
That's right.
I don't know how much that technology costs, but we want that.
That's right.
Amen. I was watching CNN News where it was demonstrated. And there was a gentleman that his image was beamed right in the studio. But he was somewhere else. And whatever he would do, of course, the image would do because it was just the image of him.
That's right.
So we want to one day get that technology where we can beam the whole image.
That's right.
And let it just stand right in the pulpit in all the churches.
In the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 7 and verse 29.
Let's get some Bible now.
In Ecclesiastes 7 and verse 29.
Follow me.
Lo, this only have I found.
This only have I found.
That God hath made man upright.
Yes.
But they have sought out.
But they have sought out.
Many inventions.
So the church from the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, Israel never had to go outside of Israel to do nothing.
That's right.
Everything that Israel needed,
that's right,
God put it within the church.
That's right.
And I see God is doing this for the truth of God.
Amen.
Everything that we need, glory to God, he's adding it line upon line.
That's right.
Precept upon precept. Here a little. There a little.
Yeah.
Amen. It's like the snowball effect. You get some good snow, and when it's good and heavy, all you have to do is get a little snowball and roll it.
That's right.
And it'll form into something big.
That's right.
I believe one scripture says, a little one shall become a thousand.
A thousand.
And that's what I'm constantly witnessing as we speak. This thing start little.
A little one.
Listen.
In the book of Isaiah, chapter 16, verse 22.
Isaiah, chapter 16.
Isaiah, chapter 60.
Isaiah, chapter 60, beg your pardon.
And verse 22. A little one.
A little one.
Shall become a thousand.
Oh, I'm seeing that now.
Oh, yeah.
I'm seeing this being fulfilled now.
That's right.
Thank the Lord. A little one, a small thing
shall become a thousand.
Glory to God, and you can hear God talking through the prophets that of the increase of his government, praise his great name, and peace there shall be no end.
That's right.
So as we now are able to do this by internet and reach the first churches of the Lord Jesus Christ the world over.
Yes.
To all the churches around the world, like I said, they have an invention where they can beam my physical body,
yeah,
a hologram, and make it appear like I'm actually in your building.
That's right.
And you're actually looking at this message being preached, not on a screen.
That's right.
But my physical body is right there in the building. And that's what we're looking at in the future.
That's right.
Where we can beam this thing there.
Amen.
Isn't that wonderful?
Amen.
To be everywhere at one time.
Amen.
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 That's a blessing.
Oh, yes.
Amen. Dan and be able to announce and greet the people. And he's everywhere.
That's right.
At one time. Williams and B won't be God now.
No.
Won't be God.
No.
Amen. But it'll be a fulfillment of prophecy.
Prophecy. That's right.
What is that prophecy? That the line that's is right. gone out.
That's
the
right.
line.
That's right.
When the line, you know, when you got a line, that line come under a lot of headings.
That's right.
Cable line. Satellite line.
That's right.
Internet line.
Amen.
Electrical line.
That line is gone out.
Spiritual line.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
It says their line.
Their line is gone out.
Where?
Through all the earth.
And what?
And their words to the end of the world.
The words is going to go Hallelujah. Through that line.
That's right.
God is going to channel
Hallelujah.
His word and carry it
Yes.
through the line that man will lay in the earth.
There is no speech nor language where their voice is not heard.
Do you hear this?
In Psalms 19 and that verse 3.
What is this? Prophecy.
That's right.
Of how God will use the carnal mind
yeah.
to seek out many inventions to get his message.
That's right.
Out to the human family.
That's right.
When I think of it, when I was a child, they didn't have this.
No.
No, sir.
Oh, no.
So we see the words of God.
That's right.
And the words of the prophets by the Spirit of God being fulfilled.
There is no speech nor language.
There is no speech. They got it now where you don't even have to speak the language of the country.
That's true.
But the signal will fall in that country in their language.
That's right.
Fulfilling prophecy.
That's right.
I don't know how to speak Arabic, but they have it now that if the signal fall into any Arab-speaking country,
Amen.
I will continue to speak English. But when the Arabs hear it, thank God, it'll come in their language. When the Hebrews hear it, it'll come. Hallelujah, blessed be God. In their language.
Amen.
What? How did this technology come about? God said.
That's right.
God said.
There is no speech nor language.
He said there is no speech. What you're saying, God, I am going to bring it so everybody under the sun can hear it in their language.
That's right.
There is no speech.
No language.
No language.
Where their voice is not heard.
Where the voice
is not heard.
Of the messengers of God is not heard.
Their line
is gone out. How you going to do it, Lord?
Yeah.
Their line
is gone out.
Praise his great name. Hallelujah. Yeah. Blessed yeah. be God.
Yeah. Their line is
the
gone out.
The line is going out.
Through all the earth.
Through all the earth.
And their words.
And their words.
To the end of the world.
And you bear in mind, Hallelujah. Once this holy message of God reached the end of the world, then the prophecy said the end comes.
That's right.
So every form of media, and I mean every form
That's right.
of media that's out here today for the advancement
yeah.
of reaching the people.
That's it.
Our media team is going to dive into it, probe into it, investigate it.
That's right.
Thank God, and then come on back to the table of counsel.
That's right.
Amen. And see how can we reach the people.
That's it.
That's my objective because it is the purpose of God.
And this gospel of the kingdom.
Blessed be God.
Hallelujah.
Do you hear this?
In Matthew chapter 24 and verse 14.
God says in Matthew 24, 14.
And this gospel of the kingdom.
This gospel of the kingdom.
Shall be preached in all the world.
Be preached everywhere.
For a witness unto all nations.
For a witness to all nations.
And then
and
shall
then
the end come.
Shall the end come.
That's right.
So I've been looking to God all these years.
Amen.
And he haven't failed me. And I'm not going to say yet.
That's right.
I'm not going to say yet because not failed me yet don't apply to him.
That's right.
And
Hallelujah.
Do you see what I'm saying? Hallelujah. Blessed be God. I ain't no need for me to say he haven't failed me yet. And if I have said it in the past, I repent, oh God.
Forgive me. That's right.
Because that's an insult to him.
That's right.
For me to say, God haven't failed me yet, that means I'm integrating a possibility.
That's right.
No, that's ain't right. No failure in him at all.
At all.
Glory to God, glory to God.
That's right.
As he purposed,
that's right.
It'll stand.
It'll stand.
Thank God, and as he thought, it'll come to pass. All right, let's go back to the book of Acts of the Apostles now.
Back in Acts chapter 2 and verse 40.
Get me.
And with many other words did he testify and
with
exhort.
Many other words did he testify and exhort, saying,
save yourselves.
From what?
From this untoward generation.
That's what I want Africa to do.
That's right.
The entire continent.
Amen.
All the islands that surround Africa and the world.
Save yourselves.
Save yourself.
From this untoward generation.
From this generation that's on its way to hell.
That's right.
Save yourself.
Save yourself.
Now, when you got in mind to save yourself, don't be surprised who may be offended at your decision.
That's right.
I was talking to a minister that I met for the first time last night here in Philadelphia. I believe he was a bishop from the, I never met him. He came here and went down in water.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ, he said a few weeks ago, he said, I've been wanting to get a chance to meet you. He said, I was a Baptist until I heard you, and I came out of that and went to the Church of God in Christ.
Yeah.
Was a bishop. Been ministering over 20-something years.
Wonderful.
He said, when I went to the Church of God in Christ, he said, I thought I'd done something. Glad to see Malawi jam-packed in the auditorium there.
Wonderful.
That's
wonderful.
A blessing.
Amen.
And when he gave me his testimony, he said, I gave up the ministry, stepped out the pulpit, and sold everything.
Amen.
To make my way here to Philadelphia.
Amen.
He said, all I want to do, glory to God, is to be saved.
That's it.
Eh?
That's it.
This is what the truth of God is centered around.
That's right.
We're not centered around no money-making scheme.
No.
We're not centered around some cheap prosperity plan.
No.
Where somebody tap you in the head and you fall out.
That's right.
Even the many of the false prophets that have invaded Africa now, mm-hmm, been influenced by the mega preaching liars.
Amen.
Here in America. T.D. Jakes and Creflo Dollar. Oh, Benny Hinn.
Yes.
All of these false prophets here in America, many of the preachers now throughout Africa have been influenced. They idolize the American hypocrites.
That's right.
Until now, the false prophets have their mega churches in Africa and getting rich.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
Getting rich.
Amen.
Why is this being done in every country? You got a mega false prophet.
That's right.
Somewhere in every country.
That's right.
Thousands.
That's right.
Thousands, yeah, is being tricked.
Oh, yes.
Being deceived. Being lied to. And they're using the name of Jesus.
And many false prophets.
Now I want you to hear this, my brothers and sisters in Africa. Hear this now.
St. Matthew chapter 24 and at verse 11.
Follow me in your Bible.
At
Matthew.
Chapter 24.
Chapter 24.
And verse 11.
And verse 11.
And many false prophets shall rise.
The Lord never put a number on it.
No.
So no need for nobody to ask me, Pastor Jennings, how many false prophets is it? I don't know.
That's right.
I just don't know.
That's right.
But one thing that I know,
and many
Jesus said,
and many false prophets,
many.
Amen.
I know it's true because they all over America.
Oh yeah.
Oh yes, they all over America. They all over America, all over Canada, South America, throughout Europe, throughout Japan, all over Africa, in the Congo, in Central Africa, North Africa, South, West, and East Africa, right there in Johannesburg, Cape Town, everywhere.
Many false prophets.
That's why I'm warning the world.
That's right.
By God's permission, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And I'm encouraging everybody,
that's
come
right.
out of the false churches. Come out.
That's right.
Come out.
That's right.
Come out.
Come out. Come out from among them.
Come out of these false churches. Come out of the
come
false
out.
Churches.
That's right.
Amen. And when you come out of the false churches, you make it up in your mind, I'm going to do this thing right.
That's right.
Amen. Just remember one thing. Brothers and sisters, just like in the Old Testament, when they offered sacrifices, now here you are of the New Testament.
That's right.
You are New Testament sacrifice.
In Romans chapter 12 and at verse 1.
Romans the 12th chapter.
And the first verse.
And the first verse says,
I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God.
What do God want?
That ye present your bodies a living sacrifice.
What kind?
Holy.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
That's what we want Africa to be presented to God.
That's right.
What kind?
Holy.
Everybody in Africa got to be holy.
That's right.
I said everybody.
That's right.
I don't care nothing about your status, your political beliefs. Amen. I don't care nothing if you are a governor,
yeah.
if you are an ambassador.
That's right.
I don't care if you're one of the members of parliament.
That's right.
Every human that walked the continent
Hallelujah.
Of Africa.
Hallelujah.
Thank God. Must.
That's right.
Must.
That's your
principle.
Must. That's right.
Must. Glory holy, to holy. God. Be holy.
Holy.
And you got to present yourself
That's
to
right.
God.
That's right.
Willingly.
That's right.
Willingly do it.
Amen.
You know, a lot of time these folk get so big, get so much money, and have such a luxurious car and a wonderful house now, and sit back smoking your cigar and
yeah.
thinking you doing God a favor because
right.
you joined some church.
That's right.
Ah!
That's right.
Hallelujah to God.
That's right.
You ain't done God no favor.
No.
God is calling for something here.
I beseech you.
Hallelujah. Glory
brethren.
To God.
Oh, yes.
I beseech you therefore, brethren.
By the mercies of God.
By God's mercy.
That ye present your bodies a living sacrifice.
How shall we give it?
Holy.
Mm.
Holy.
You see, this message of holiness
Amen.
Is for everybody.
That's right.
You that are listening in Mozambique, Malawi, Johannesburg, or wherever else,
Amen.
This message, Mauritia, for holiness,
That's right.
Cape Town, is for everybody.
That's right.
God want the entire continent of Africa to be holy.
Holy.
And you're not holy because you're black.
No.
You're not holy because that's the first piece of land that God made man.
That's right.
No!
That's right.
Glory to God, you're holy because you have repented of your sins.
Amen.
Been baptized in water in the name of Jesus Christ.
That's right.
You have the blessed Holy Ghost.
That's right.
Speaking in tongue at the Spirit of God give utterance.
Hallelujah.
And you're striving to live
right.
a holy, sanctify, set apart,
That's right.
a life set aside
That's right.
for God's glory.
That's right.
Eh?
That's right.
You see, the message of holiness is a message of sanctification.
That's right.
What do you mean, sanctification? You know, when you sanctify, you're set apart.
That's right.
Eh?
This is the will of God.
Yeah. You have unrighteous sanctification, and you have righteous
Amen.
Sanctification.
That's right.
You see, when you are a sinner, you are unrighteously sanctified.
That's right.
For the usage
yeah.
of the devil.
Know ye not?
You see, you set aside so the devil can use you.
That's right.
But when you come on God's side,
yeah.
Now you are sanctified, so God can use you.
That's right.
You know, there's a scripture in the Old Testament that says the priests had not sanctified themselves sufficiently.
That's right.
In other words, they didn't separate themselves for God the right way. Africa, we come in the name of the Lord Jesus to teach you God's method of sanctification.
That's right.
God's way.
That's right.
Of sanctification. Not Pastor Jennings' way.
No.
Not your way.
No.
But God wants a people to be sanctified.
That's right.
And holy.
That's right.
You know, sanctified and holy. Set apart, set aside, that he may use you for his glory.
That's right.
Now you that are watching and listening, you have to want God to get the glory, the pleasure out of your life.
That's right.
That's what it means when it says God want to get the glory out of your life. That means God want to get the pleasure.
That's right.
Out of your life.
That's right.
Eh?
That's right.
Glory to God. Did you hear what I said?
That's right.
You know, you have heard for years that God want to get the glory.
Glory.
Out of your life, and many people don't understand what that means.
Amen.
That simply means God want to get the pleasure out of your life.
That's right.
Amen. God wants you to give him pleasure.
In Isaiah chapter 43 and at verse 6.
Well, how do I give God pleasure, Pastor Jennings? By giving him service.
That's right.
By giving him your time. By offering yourself to him so he can extract from your body all his will.
That's right.
Ah!
That's right.
Glory to God.
That's right.
You know,
hallelujah.
When somebody have to get go through chemotherapy, they abstract blood, then the blood go through a filter, get cleansed, and then it come back.
That's right.
God wants to abstract, glory to God, all the pleasure that you can possibly give them from your body. But he wanted it done on his terms.
That's right.
Are you listening?
That's right.
So viewers, what do you mean, Pastor Jennings? Look at the pleasure you get out of using your hands. And God wants you to use them for him.
That's right.
Look at the pleasure you get out of looking at things. God wants you to look at the things that he wants you to see.
That's right.
Look at the pleasure you get out of just hearing things. God wants you to hear the things that he wants you to hear.
That's right.
Look at the pleasure you get out of using your mouth. Yeah. God wants you to use your mouth in a manner that he get pleasure out of.
That's right.
So every part of your physical body, glory to God. That's why he said present
your body.
Your body.
A living sacrifice.
He wants all the members of the body to be alive and sanctified, giving him service.
That's right.
That's why now, when you got a mind to be holy, hallelujah, bless God, he want that hand that used to pick up the liquor bottle, take that same hand,
that's right,
and put the liquor bottle down.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
Why? Now, what? You change pleasure.
That's right. Man. That's right.
He wants you, just like you got pleasure, lift in the bottle, and it gave you joy.
Yeah.
Now, when you lift it up to drink, you made the devil happy.
That's right.
Now, God wants you to take the bottle and put it down, and don't lift it no more,
right,
and that'll make God happy.
That's right.
Now, do you see?
That's right.
Glory to God.
I beseech you therefore, brethren.
Give chapter and verse so the churches of the Lord Jesus Christ can follow me.
Romans chapter 12 and we're at verse 1.
We're at Romans The 12th chapter.
And the first verse.
And the first verse.
I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God.
I am getting your attention, brothers.
By the mercies of God.
By God's compassion.
That ye present your bodies a living sacrifice.
That you offer yourselves to God.
A living sacrifice.
A living sacrifice, holy.
Holy, acceptable unto God.
It have to be so that God will accept it.
That's right.
And then you'll give him.
Which is your reasonable service.
Reasonable service.
That's right.
All right, let's go back to the second chapter of Acts of the Apostles. I want to take my time because I want everybody to give this.
Amen.
That's why I have to pace myself, you know.
Yeah.
Because I want everybody to get this.
Yes.
All right, follow me and hear me.
Back in Acts chapter 2, and we're at verse 40.
All right.
And with many other words did he testify and exhort, saying, save yourselves.
With many.
With many other words.
You know, I want to say to my young brothers and sisters throughout the churches from the Lord Jesus Christ in Africa, God wants you to save yourself while you're young.
That's right.
I know it's hard. You know why? Your body is full of lust.
That's right.
Oh yeah, you want to fornicate, you want to hug, you want to kiss, you want to do dance, and you want to party, you want to smoke, amen, you want to drink, you want to do all that stuff.
That's right.
But this is why sanctification is a requirement from God.
That's right.
And it brings about mental, emotional, physical restraint.
That's right.
In other words, when I would do good, evil is present, but I restrain myself because I have agreed to sanctify myself.
That's right.
Sufficiently.
That's right.
And now that I'm striving for sanctification, to set myself aside.
That's right.
Glory to God.
That's right.
For the glory of God, or for the pleasure of God, then I must offer myself to God so God can be happy with everything I do.
Wonderful.
With my body.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
Why? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Because my body. Now let me make it more plain.
Yeah.
In the Old Testament, they took a lamb or an ox and laid it upon the altar that it may be sacrificed or offered up.
That's right.
To the Lord.
That's right.
And if it's offered to the Lord, right? He got pleased with it.
That's right.
Africa, your physical body is a sacrifice.
That's right.
Amen. You that is in the first church of the Lord Jesus Christ, and you not married, you can't be kissing each other.
No.
Can't be hugging and smooching and. Amen. You can't be fornicating.
That's right.
You can't be sneaking to that sister's house and that brother sneaking. And that sister sneaking to the brother's house.
That's right.
You got to be sanctified. Even if you're Skyping each other.
Mm-hmm.
Or FaceTiming each other.
Yeah.
Glory to God.
Right.
Your Skype and your FaceTime got to be clean.
That's right.
You can't be FaceTiming, you ain't got no clothes on, sister.
That's right.
You can't be FaceTiming, you ain't got no clothes on, brother.
That's right.
Eh?
That's right.
Glory to God. You can't say nothing inappropriate.
Yeah.
Even when all the ministers hold services on Zoom.
That's true.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Yeah, you dress right.
That's right.
Nothing is said in a Zoom meeting. I don't care if it's one at the screen or 1,000.
That's right.
Nothing,
that's
blessed
right.
be the great creator,
amen.
Can be said that will violate sanctification.
That's right.
You see, when the Bible calls for sanctification, my very mouth has to be set aside where only the language of the Heavenly Father is uttered.
That's right.
That way he approve.
That's right.
of my speech.
That's right.
Eh?
That's
why, right. Why? By thine words, you're justified.
That's right.
And by thine words, thou shalt be condemned.
Yeah.
You know, sometime on cell phones and on a computer, they have what is called emojis.
Emojis.
No, emojis, little images.
Yes.
Amen. Little images. Well, if that sister is not your wife, she should not be on the receiving end of some red lips emoji.
That's right.
From a brother.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Don't even send her a emoji heart.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
That's right.
Amen.
1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and verse 22.
Someone say, well, Pastor Jennings, that's my way of saying that I love you. Well, just say, well, I love you in Jesus' name. You ain't got to send emojis because it'd be misinterpreted.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
Amen. And the Bible says.
In 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and we're at verse 22.
You see, I didn't have this in mind, but because the Holy Ghost is bringing this to mind, because this is a virtual reality service.
That's right.
And I have to address the evil of virtual reality.
That's right.
There's evils involved.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Because each emoji have a meaning.
That's true.
Yeah?
That's true.
And I don't care how innocent your objective was, the Holy Book says don't let your good be evil spoken of.
That's right.
Amen. Listen at this.
1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and we're at verse 22.
Says what?
Abstain from all appearance.
Wait.
Abstain.
From how much?
From all appearance of evil. Abstain.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
I can't send emoji to a sister of that little yellow face with the lips puckering up.
That's right. That's right.
Can't do that.
Abstain.
That's not your wife. You can't do that.
That's right.
No, sir.
That's right.
Do you hear how, you see, God saw this.
Yeah.
He saw how men sought out many inventions. Then he come back with scripture that teach the church how to use them and how not to use them, where the discretion of heaven must be applied.
That's right.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
That's right.
You know, this is the Lord's doing.
Yes, it is.
Amen. And it's marvelous in our eyes because God, you don't find carnal-minded preachers even thinking on this manner to preach it.
No.
That's why it takes God to give someone a spiritual mind and even make him think of what he never thought of.
That's true.
Why? For the salvation of the church.
That's right.
Listen now.
1 Thessalonians 5 and verse 22.
That's what?
Abstain from all appearance of
all
evil.
Of it.
All of it.
All of it.
All
so
of it.
If there's any fornication in the churches of Africa.
That's right.
You might as well get ready to bring it to an end.
That's right.
Eh?
That's right.
Bring it to an end.
Abstain.
Amen. That's not your wife. Get out of the bed with her.
That's right.
No kissing. Get your tongue out of her mouth. Am I right?
That's right.
Get your tongue out of her mouth.
Amen.
Get your hand out of her back pocket.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
The Holy Ghost says.
Abstain.
Give the chapter and verse now.
1 Thessalonians
Amen. Remember,
five.
We're talking to a whole different continent, and they got the following in the Bible.
Amen.
Listen.
1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and verse 22.
Thessalonians. 1 Thessalonians.
Chapter 5.
The fifth chapter and verse 22. I want you to read what I'm talking.
That's right.
Jot the scriptures down.
That's right.
And that way when your brother, amen, text you and say, well, look, we're going to meet tonight. You have texted them back 1 Thessalonians.
Chapter 5.
5:22.
Verse 22. That's right.
Oh, we'll take God.
Oh, yes.
What did he say?
Abstain from all appearance of evil.
Abstain.
Abstain.
From the look of it.
That's right.
Yeah.
It says abstain from the appearance. That means back away. From the look of it.
Abstain from all appearance of evil.
Now, that means this. It may not be evil.
Right.
But it has the appearance I better back off.
Yeah.
Because if I try to investigate, I may not be able to get away.
That's true.
Eh?
That's right.
Do you hear the wisdom of God?
1 Thessalonians 5 and verse 22.
Says what?
Abstain from all appearance of evil.
Only God come up with this.
That's right.
Abstain.
Abstain from all appearance of evil.
Do you hear this?
Amen.
Abstain.
Abstain.
From the look.
Of evil.
Of evil.
And the very God of peace.
And the God of peace.
Sanctify you wholly.
There it is.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Blessed be God. The God
of peace.
Of peace.
Sanctify you wholly.
So if you talking to a brother or a sister in any of the first churches of the Lord Jesus Christ in America, whether it's by email or by text messages, amen, by Skype or Zoom or whatever, amen, your conversation have to be holy. That doesn't mean that when you're talking, you have to be quoting scriptures, talking about Paul, James, John, and Brother Jeremiah. No, that simply means that your conversation must be sanctified, wherein nothing is said that affects you in judgment when the Lord comes.
That's right. Amen. That's right.
Yeah, you're not saying anything that you should not say.
That's right.
But you're holy.
Holy.
Eh?
That's right.
You're holy.
Abstain from all appearance of
evil. Even if you got a custom in different parts of Africa.
Yeah.
But that custom is contrary to the custom of God.
That's right.
Then that custom, thank God, got to come to an end.
That's right.
Only if it contradicts the principles of God.
That's
Do
right.
you hear this?
Back in 1 Thessalonians 5 and verse 22.
Thessalonians, 1 Thessalonians 5, 22.
Abstain from all appearance of evil.
Wait a minute. When you're standing in the church, in the churches, or on a church ground, talking to a sister, then you don't want to be looking at the sister up and down.
That's right.
You want to be looking at the brother up and down.
That's right.
You don't want your conduct to be misinterpreted as evil.
That's right.
Eh?
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
The Holy Book says,
abstain from,
back off
from all,
get away from.
That's right.
From how much?
From all appearance of evil.
This is what the Holy Ghost brought here today.
Amen.
Abstain from all.
All appearance of evil.
All of it.
All of it.
You know, we even tell the saints, when they take pictures, sometimes group shots, when our photographers, Brother Huey and Sister Bailey and others, take pictures. And if that brother and sister's not married, don't be all hugged up.
That's right.
Taking some pictures. Oh, no.
That's right.
You can stand next to each other, but you ain't got to lock in.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
No, sir.
That's right.
No, no.
Amen.
Not at all.
Not at all.
You hear this now?
Abstain from all appearance.
Abstain.
Of evil. Abstain from all appearance.
Back away. If it
evil.
Just look wrong, yes. Back away.
That's right.
Yeah?
That's right.
Hey, man, what you mean? Now, if it look wrong by the appearance, and the appearance look like it contradicts Scripture.
That's right. Abstain.
It may not contradict Scripture. But if it look like it does,
abstain.
The appearance of it.
That's right.
Back away from it.
That's right.
You know, here in America, when I was coming up, they had bubble gum look like cigarettes.
Right.
Do you remember that?
Yes.
And the bubble gum was wrapped in fake cigarette wrapping.
That's right.
They even had the part that looked like the filter. And little kids will be out there holding it.
That's right.
And in the wintertime, you know, the heat of your mouth blows smoke, so it makes it look like they're smoking.
Yeah.
Huh?
That's right.
Well, the Bible speaks plain.
Abstain from all appearance of evil.
You don't even want to put nothing up to your mouth
that look like a cigarette.
That's right.
That look like a cigar.
That's right.
That look like a pipe.
Amen.
That look like a joint or weed.
That's right.
Mm-mm.
That's right.
Huh?
Abstain from
abstain.
All appearance.
This is the scriptures here.
First Thessalonians.
And this type of teaching is obsolete from churches. You see, God is a holy God.
Yes,
he don't think like we think. He don't view things like we view it. So he wants you to know how he think, the way he think, and how he feel. So he sent men to write down his emotions, his thoughts, his feelings in the form of prophecy and doctrine and scripture and laid it out for the world.
That's right.
So the world can be exposed to how God thinks.
That's right.
How God feels.
Yeah.
How God views things.
That's right.
That's right.
That's right.
And God thoughts is unusual to us.
Oh, yes.
We would not even fathom the thoughts that God had.
No.
We would not even come up with the thinking of anything that God had.
That's right.
That's why it is recommended by God.
Abstain from all appearance.
Let this mind
be
in you. That's also in Christ Jesus.
That's
a scriptural recommendation.
That's right.
He wants you to have his mind. The mind transforms the body.
That's right.
The carnal mind keeps the body indulging in carnal behavior.
That's right.
The spiritual mind liberates the body from being captivated or imprisoned by the deeds of carnality or the deeds of the flesh.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So as a spiritual preacher, I have to bring myself under subjection.
That's right.
And why? My mind is not always spiritual.
That's right.
So I have to give in to the spiritual thoughts of God that it may overpower. Overpower.
Right.
You know, there's some computer things, you got to override the system.
Yeah.
Glory to God. The word of God has to override our way of thinking.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
Have to override our will.
That's
override
right.
our heart. Thank God until we're washed and cleansed and filled with God.
That's right.
Do you see what I'm telling you?
That's right.
Amen. Go back to the book of Acts.
Back in Acts chapter 2 and at verse 40.
Follow me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Follow me in the scriptures here.
And with many other words did he testify and exhort.
Doing what?
Saying, save yourself.
With many other words did he testify and exhort, saying, save yourself.
From this untoward generation.
U.S., Africa, Africa, Africa.
Yeah.
Do you want to be saved today or do you want to go to hell?
My Lord.
The word of God is preached.
That's right.
They keep the entire continent from hell.
That's right.
Think of it. God sent one message to save not just a continent, but the world.
That's right.
If they just be willing and obedient and walk according to God's everlasting word.
That's right.
The Bible says what?
And with many other words did he testify and exhort.
Saying?
Saying, save yourselves from this untoward generation.
Yes.
Then they that gladly received his word were
they
baptized.
They that gladly.
Amen.
Gladly. Glad about it.
Gladly.
You know, if you're glad about it, you want to obey it.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
Amen. When you're glad about it, you want to obey it. You that is in Malawi, Mozambique, and Johannesburg, Cape Town, Mauritius, Rodriguez, amen, wherever you are, you have to be glad about the word.
That's right.
When you are glad about it, nobody got to fight you to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ.
That's right.
When you're glad about it, you give God your mind.
Yeah.
Give God your heart. Yes. Give God your body. No, it won't be no hesitation.
No.
Whatsoever. Amen. When the question is asked, do anybody want to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ? You will jump out your chair.
Yes, you will.
Why? Because you want God to have your body.
Hallelujah.
That's right. You want God to have your body. You want God to sanctify you. You want God to make you holy.
Hallelujah.
Thank God, because in this life, there's nothing better
than
being holy.
That's right.
Oh, it's no maybe so. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. No maybe so about that.
There's nothing.
There's nothing under the sun.
Hallelujah.
That's better than being holy.
That's right. Then they that gladly received his word.
Glory to God. They that gladly
received his word.
God's word.
Were baptized.
Oh, they were baptized.
And the same day there were added unto them about 3,000 souls.
Look at the many that done came in throughout the continent of Africa.
Amen.
And this is not everybody.
No.
This is just a few locations
that's
able to log on, but there's many, 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 many more.
Oh, yeah.
I don't see Tanzania today.
Amen.
Don't see Kenya today.
Yeah.
I don't see the Ivory Coast today. I don't see Zimbabwe. I don't see Zambia. I don't see the Congo. I don't see Nigeria. Why? There's many. Thank God that have fell under the hammer of this gospel.
That's right.
Wanting to be right.
That's right.
Wanting to be holy. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be God wanting to be right.
That's right.
Amen. And I thank God that he chose the truth of God message.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ordained it.
Hallelujah.
Thank God that it'll go, amen, around the world to collect souls that gather up sheep.
That's right.
For God of heaven says, my sheep, hallelujah, my sheep, thank God shall hear my voice. Blessed be God and the stranger. Thank God they won't follow.
That's right.
So it's a blessing now.
Oh, yes.
When you're able to leave the stranger.
Amen.
The stranger is the false prophet.
That's right.
Amen. It's a blessing now. When you're able to come out of the false religion,
The
fake religion, the Baptist, the Methodist, the so-called evangelical, them that pose to be apostolic, and the Catholic, because you know the Catholic churches is all over Africa. All over Africa, Catholic pagan churches got the African men and women bowing to statues, praying to images, praying to idols, which is a demonic practice. We don't bow to no statue. We don't bow to no image.
Amen.
But we bow to Jehovah, which is the God of Israel.
That's right.
Yeah.
And with many other words.
Say God.
Hallelujah.
With
many other words did he testify and exhort.
God with many other words.
Did he testify and exhort?
Did he testify
and exhort?
And built up the people.
Saying, save yourself.
Do what?
Save yourself.
All of you in Africa that are watching, if you got a little statue of a little white Jesus or a little brown Jesus, a little white Mary, a little brown Mary, a little white Joseph, a little brown Joseph, you take them images and that statue out of your house and throw it in the trash. Smash it up.
That's right.
Smash it up first.
That's right.
Amen. That way when you throw it in the trash, you ain't tempted to reach back down there and get it out.
Amen.
Smash it up.
That's right.
Throw it away.
Throw it away.
Thank God our God is not on no shelf.
No.
Our God is not worn around the neck.
Hallelujah. Our God is in the heavens.
Our God
is in the heavens.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be the name of the Most High.
Hallelujah.
Our God.
Our God is in the heavens.
Thanks be unto God.
Hallelujah.
Our God is in the heavens.
He hath done whatsoever he hath pleased.
He done whatever pleased him.
Their idols are silver and gold.
So you come along and get rid of all idols.
That's
don't ever bow or pray to no picture.
That's right.
No statue.
That's right.
We bow to God himself.
That's right.
He's sufficient enough.
That's right.
Huh?
And with many other words.
Go back to the book of Acts, the second chapter.
And at verse 40.
And verse 40.
And with many other words.
With many other words
did he exalt.
Did he testify and exalt, saying,
save yourselves from this untoward generation.
This afternoon and tonight, Africa, that's what I'm telling you now.
Save yourselves.
That's what I'm telling you. telling you now.
That's right.
Yeah, that's what I'm telling you. You save yourself. If your mother or your father or your wife or your husband don't want you to get right, you ignore them and get right anyway.
That's right.
Repent of your sins.
That's right.
Johannesburg, repent of your sins. Mozambique, repent of your sins. Malawi, repent of your sins. Cape Town, repent of your sins.
Yeah.
Who? Everybody.
That's right.
Repent.
And be baptized.
What you mean repent? Be sorry for your wrong.
That's right.
And get ready to be baptized.
Every one of you.
Every one of you.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
For the remission of sin.
That's the way you get your sins washed away.
And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
And God will fill you with himself.
For the promise.
Yeah, the Holy Ghost is the Spirit of God.
That's right.
When you receive the Holy Ghost, you're filled with God.
That's right.
Huh?
That's
I say when you receive the Holy Ghost, you are filled. Filled with God.
Amen.
Amen. That's when you have the Holy Ghost, God is in you.
That's right.
And God come in you to clean you up.
Oh, yeah.
It won't happen overnight.
No.
No. It won't happen overnight, but it's a gradual cleansing process.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
Now, in order for you to be clean gradually, you have to hear God's word.
That's right.
It is written, you're clean. Through the word that I speak unto you.
Right.
So God give the world a chance to get clean, to get right, to get their sins rid of by the preaching of the gospel of God.
Right.
What is written in the book of Acts?
And with many other words did he
chapter and verse again.
Acts chapter 2 and at verse 40.
With many other words did he testify and exhort, saying,
save yourselves from this untoward generation.
Yes.
Then they that gladly received his word were baptized.
Now, Africa, if any of you are glad, and all of you ought to be glad about this word.
That's right.
I'm so glad that God have made provisions. Have made provisions for us.
Amen.
That this is made possible by the hand of God.
That's right.
God made it possible.
That's right.
Think of it. Most preachers have come down to Africa and other countries taken from the people.
Yeah.
But here we come, given to the people.
Amen.
Eh?
Amen.
Amen. We wanted to make sure that the churches can do this.
Yeah.
Amen. So we sent, amen, thousands of dollars in some cases.
Wonderful.
To make sure they're able to get the equipment.
Right.
Set it up.
Yeah.
Amen. Why? Our objective is not to take nothing from you.
That's right.
But to give you God's word.
That's right.
I have to say like the Apostle Paul, I warn you. And not yours.
That's right.
I want your soul.
That's right.
I don't want your possessions. Hallelujah. But I want your soul. Glory to God to get right with God. So this is what we are determined to do throughout the entire continent of Africa and the rest of the world.
That's right.
Amen. This is the Lord's doing, and it is God's will, and it is God's purpose that you hear this, and by
testify and exhort,
that it testify and exhort,
saying, save yourself,
from this untoward generation.
Then they that gladly received his word were baptized.
They were baptized.
And the same day there were added unto them about 3,000
souls. More souls came in the church.
And they
it was about 3,000 that was added to the church.
That's right.
And what?
And they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine.
That means this. They continue steadfastly in the teachings of Jesus.
That's right.
You see, the apostles' doctrine mean it's the teaching of Jesus given to the apostles from Jesus, and they spread that teaching around the world.
Right.
Now that same doctrine or that same teaching is back again.
Amen.
Making the same go round.
That's right.
To the world.
That's right.
Glory to God. Glory to God.
That's right.
They did what?
And they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine.
Steadfast.
Steadfast.
You can't steadfast in something continuously that you don't know.
That's true.
That you haven't learned.
That's right.
So I have to bring the doctrine of Jesus.
Yeah.
The teaching of Jesus.
Right.
to govern the church.
That's right.
That way, Malawi had the same thing that we're preaching.
That's right.
Mozambique had the same thing that we're preaching.
That's right.
Johannesburg have the same thing that we preaching.
That's
Cape
right.
Town have the same thing.
Yeah.
Mauritius have the same thing.
That's right.
Amen. The Ivory Coast have the same thing. Nigeria,
yeah.
It doesn't matter where you are.
That's right.
There's one gospel.
Amen.
One message.
Amen.
That's why I thank God for Bishop Simbali and Pastor Joshua and Pastor Benny. Amen. And the ministers that work along with them. They are determined, Minister Haji and others, they are determined to stick to the same method.
That's right.
Yeah?
That's right.
Amen. Thank God. I thank God for that.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And when I see them brothers sticking to the same message, they have no idea of the comfort and the joy that I obtain.
Wonderful.
Until I have to testify like Paul, when he testified about Titus, he said how he was greatly comforted by the appearance of Titus. Amen. So I'm greatly comforted, amen, by the ministers in Africa that's determined to feed the church the same food. Same food. Amen. This is not an American gospel.
No.
This is not a Geno Jennings gospel.
No, no.
Glory to God. This is the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ.
That's right.
And you bear in mind, it's not another.
Not another.
I say it's not another.
Not another.
Amen. It's not another gospel under the sun, but the gospel that Jesus gave his apostles.
Right.
What everybody watching got to do now?
Acts 2 and verse 40. Save yourselves from this untoward generation.
Do you hear this?
Amen.
Time for you to save yourself.
Save yourselves.
How do I save myself, Pastor Jennings? Then Peter.
Then in Acts chapter 2 and verse 38.
Yeah.
Then Peter said unto them, repent.
Here it is.
Amen.
That's right.
Be sorry about your wrong.
That's right.
Amen. You're convicted.
Amen.
About your sins.
Yeah.
You want God to forgive you. You ask God to forgive you.
That's right.
And you mean it.
That's right.
Amen. Are you listening?
Yeah.
Repent.
Then Peter said unto them, repent.
Said unto them, repent.
And be baptized every one of you.
That same spirit that's in Peter is in the church now.
That's right.
It's the Holy Ghost. That's why Peter stood up and preached it with the Holy Ghost sent down from heaven. And God Almighty, through and by the Holy Ghost, will move on men to stand up today and preach the same thing.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
Then Peter
said unto them, repent.
Be sorry, Africa. Africa. Africa, be sorry. Repent.
Repent and be baptized.
And be baptized.
Every one of you.
Yeah.
All of you.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
For the remission of sins.
To get your sins washed away.
And ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
And you'll be filled with God.
For the promise is unto you.
God promised that he'll fill you with the Holy Ghost.
And to your children.
And your children he'll fill them also.
And to all that are
even them that's far away.
Even as many as the Lord our God shall call.
Even as many as the Lord our God shall what?
Shall call.
And the Bible says the Lord have spoken.
Yes.
He have called the whole earth.
Yes.
Glory to God, from the rising of the sun.
That's right.
To the going down thereof.
That's right.
All right, Africa. If there's anybody in Malawi, Mozambique, Johannesburg, Cape Town, Mauritius Islands, or anybody else that's watching, want to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ that have not obtained it, stand on your feet this evening there. If you want to be baptized, stand on your feet if you want it. Stand on your feet now if you want to be baptized. Amen.
Amen.
Wonderful. If you want to be baptized,
amen.
Isn't that wonderful?
That's wonderful.
Glory to God.
That's wonderful.
All of you, all the ministers that are there in your location, all of them that want to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ.
Wonderful.
You baptize everybody. Look at that. Look at the many standing.
Wonderful.
That wants to be baptized.
Amen.
Isn't that wonderful?
Wonderful.
And this is just Friday, for goodness sake.
That's right.
Eh?
That's right.
Amen. My net have broken.
Oh, yeah.
Eh? Amen. We are through the net out today.
Hallelujah.
Oh, thank God. And it has broken, I said.
Hallelujah.
So to my ministers that is there in Mozambique and Malawi, I want you to baptize all those that want to be baptized and contact us back, email us this weekend, and let us know how many went down in water in the name of Jesus Christ, so we can let the world know.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That this thing did not fall in vain. So get them ready today if you can.
Right.
And baptize them in the name of Jesus Christ. All right, come on back tomorrow. And when we thunder after you again, amen, with God's everlasting word. All right, we're going to ask everybody to stand, and we're going to close out with prayer. And all of you that stood to be baptized, Pastor Benny and Pastor Joshua and the ministers, baptize all of them in the name of Jesus Christ that want to be baptized, and give us a report today or by tomorrow so we can let the folks know. I know this thing is not falling in vain. It's God's will. All right, let us all pray. Eternal, everlasting God, we thank you once again for fulfilling, hallelujah, your divine word. The line have went out, and it is your will that it continue to go out to all the earth. Today, you took it to Africa. Glory to God. And we are thankful, hallelujah, for the hearts that were pricked to obey your divine word. We thank you for the faithfulness of the ministers, for the brothers and the sisters that want to obey your word. We thank you for moving on men to fulfill your word, to seek out many inventions. Now we ask you to make it possible that whatever you see that can be used to reach the world, give it to the church. Give it to the church that the world may bow before heaven and understand that only God is God, and there's none, glory to God, likened unto thee. Keep us and preserve us as we go back to our separate places until we come back on tomorrow with the word of the Lord. We thank you so much.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We thank you for the fulfillment of your word. Hallelujah. Keep us and preserve us in thine will. Thanks be unto God. Let the viewers that will get a chance to see this message around the world, let their heart be pricked.
Hallelujah.
That they also may repent of their sin.
Hallelujah.
And be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ from the four corners of the earth. We thank thee, Lord God Almighty, for being a God of truth. These blessings we ask in the name of the Lord Jesus. Let every heart say amen. All right, come on back tomorrow. We thank God for you. So to our saints that is in Africa, to all the ministers, baptize all of those that stood to be baptized, and let us know sometime later on tomorrow how many were baptized in your area from this message, that we may glorify God with you, because God has been good and he is good. May God keep you, may God preserve you is our prayer. All right, you've dismissed. Thanks, sir.